All right, here we go. We have the bridge between Ottawa's finest and Toronto's finest right now. Yusso, how are you doing today, man?
I'm good, man. How are you?
Doing all right. You know, thank you for coming by to the Lens of Yashu for the very first time and all that, you know, and even just like meeting each other like at your EP release party and like just presenting like a lot of like dope music that you've had so far too. Like, it was like a dope experience, and you know, it made me like interested like in that sense to have you on here, you know, and then also with everything else going on too, you know, like just like realizing your story right now, like you tend to have like an interesting story, and you've been doing this like for a while now, you know.
100%. I've been doing it for a while. Thank you for pulling up to the EP release shoot, by the way. I hope you had fun. Did you get to taste any of the juice?
Yeah, the juices were actually pretty good so far, you know. Like, I think I've had this like one juice. I think it was like more like a cranberry or like mango type thing, or like a celery type thing.
Yeah, they had the two types. Shout out to Asay Juicery. Yeah. Asay Juicery for sure.
And also, you know, just like reaching out, like, you know, when I just found it out from you, like more from the message and more from everything else too, I just had to do like my research for a bit, and like you're not like really new at this at all, you know, you've been here like doing your thing for a while too, but like Ottawa based, but then you just moved to Toronto for a bit, and like now you're making waves like either way right now, you know, which is like pretty interesting, you know.
It's like, you know what it is, I've been doing it for a minute, but it's to what level I've been doing it. So I think the level that I'm doing it now is very different for me, and that's what makes it feel like new and refreshing. But yeah, I have been going at it for a while, but yeah, it's levels, it's definitely levels.
Okay. Well, you know, this is like your first time right now on TLOY, so I just wanted to get into your story for a bit too, so.
Lens of Yashu.
Pretty much, man. So you were born in Bulgaria, that's correct?
Born in Bulgaria, yeah. Raised in Ottawa.
True. So you were born in Sofia, Bulgaria?
Or? No, that's the capital actually, but it's a place called Elin Pellin. Yeah, Elin Pellin, Bulgaria. I had to meet a couple Bulgarians while being out to... I used to call it Elin Pellin, but it's Elin Pellin. Elin Pellin, Bulgaria. Yeah.
So, and like growing up in Bulgaria and like in Ottawa too, so like the area that you grew up in Bulgaria and like the area that you lived in Ottawa, like which are those like areas did you grow up at, and what was like the environment like for you growing up as well as like a childhood? Would you say that it was like a very dope experience growing up in both areas, or would it be different?
In terms of Bulgaria, my parents actually left with me when I was 10 months old, so they took me and my two brothers by then had been born in prior countries, Libya, Ghana. So when we got to Bulgaria, my parents left with me when I was 10 months, so I don't really have much of an experience in there, but from what my parents told me, there's not a lot of, like, I guess, black people thriving there. It's more so a lot of place, it's a place where a lot of Ghanaians journey to as like a stepping stone to getting here. Some make it and some don't. So you'll go to Bulgaria now and you'll still see some like homeless Ghanaians, but it's because along the route of their journey, they just didn't make it to the finish of either America or Canada. So that's what it's like there. In terms of Ottawa, though, growing up in Ottawa, I grew up in the South End, Heatherington to be exact. That was, looking back on it now, it was blessed. It was actually blessed. There was obviously turmoil, different things, but it was actually blessed. It was super blessed.
And you stated that you managed to like live in like Libya for a bit, and then you lived like in Ghana, like I guess like that.
No, so here's the thing. My parents traveled a lot before getting here, so that had to do with some other shit. But my parents literally went from Ghana to Libya to Bulgaria, Paris. Then they came to Montreal first. Then we settled in Ottawa. So in Ghana, that's when one brother was born. Went to Libya. My other brother was born there. Bulgaria, I was born there, and my parents kept traveling, so.
As like a Ghanaian, like in like Bulgaria, like in that sense too, like I guess like it's just like a weird like culture shock, like in that sense for a bit too.
I think for my parents more so than me, I adjusted pretty well to life here, but I think culture shock wise, I'd say that'd be like my parents' experience more than anything. Because I got what I was fed at home, and then what I was fed outside of the house in terms of culture. So I was able to take both things in as new things. So the whole culture shock thing wasn't really, I guess, there for me more than anything, yeah.
Yeah, no doubt, man. Like in Ottawa, like right now, I know like Ottawa, like it has like an amazing like music scene from CP Records. Like I don't know if you knew like CP Records back then. Like
you have this history with that. This history with that. I don't know if anybody knows Belly's history that deep, but even with CP Records, there's history with that. Huge history with that.
And like they had like a lot of like dope artists like Danny Fernandez,
Masari too,
and then also Mia Martina. I was thinking Sean Desmond too, but I don't think he was signed to CP.
I don't think he was. Sean Desmond was just another Canadian who put on for Canada in terms of music and everything and branching out, but
But also with Ottawa too, like they have like a lot of like dope rappers too with Night Lavelle, Princess Bree, who's actually from Ottawa but relocated to Toronto like a while back too. City Fidelia that you already like know in that sense too. Blue Will, and like a whole lot of like other dope acts like the FTG crew, FTG Metro, like Rest in Peace and all that, and then Two Time. So like in Ottawa, like even back then with CP, was it like a big place for music at the time too, in terms of being like industry? Like
when Capital Profits was doing anything?
Like around that time, you know,
yeah. No, it wasn't like a huge scene. It was not a huge scene. That's why it was so big when Belly and Masari did their thing. There was not really a lot of foundation, I guess, for artists to blossom. There was not a lot of platforms. But in terms of artistry and artists being there, I feel like that's something that's always been there. Like the artists have been there. Yeah, if you go down there, you mingle around for a bit, you'll notice the artist and how they do their own art to a level has always been there.
Yeah.
And you know, like when you started like your music career like in Ottawa too, like I know like we'll touch more on that, but like when you moved from Ottawa and now Toronto, like what was like the transition like, you know, just even like moving from like one area to another, or like adapting to like Western culture, you know, from Bulgaria to like Paris to like Ottawa and all that, you know, like as far as like the culture, the attitudes and much more?
For me, the transition was pretty smooth because, like I said, I didn't have that culture shock. But in terms of from Ottawa to Toronto, that was a bit rough because I kind of came here with nothing. Not even kind of. I came here with, I think, $40, but that's a whole other story. Luckily, I had the homie who I had here. He kind of took me under his wing for a little bit too, like at least a year or two, showed me like the ropes of Toronto, how to get around job wise and things like that, hustling a little bit. But yeah, the transition, I say, from Ottawa to Toronto was a lot more rough than Bulgaria to here. But yeah.
Damn.
No doubt, man.
Super unprofessional, my bad.
Nah, no worries. We'll cut that like from that part too. Like once, like that phone rang for a bit too.
Yeah. It could be.
Yeah, it could be. But like, yeah, no worries. But like Ottawa, like from Ottawa to Toronto, like it wasn't like, was it? Were there other reasons for moving, like aside from the music stuff, or was that like the main reason, like for that bit too?
So like, I don't even know if people know it, or even like if people who are even in my inner circle know it. But my move to Toronto was never because of music. That was in terms of personal reasons, like who I was as a person, the momentum that was being had in my life. I just needed more. I needed more change. I needed more situations where it would push me towards getting to know who I was. So I needed more situations where I had to figure it out just to know the person that I was, because I was at a point in the city based on what I was doing and how I was moving. It got to a comfortable point. Like every decision I would make, I knew what it would get to. I knew where it would lead to, and it was just, I didn't feel like I was making any kind of rigorous change in me, and I needed that. It wasn't feeding my soul from what I was doing. But I can say one thing: since moving, I have appreciated the city way more. Ottawa is its own beast. Toronto is its own beast. Every city, every place, every postal code, every whatever around the city, around the world, actually, is its own beast, you know?
No, most definitely, man. And you know, I want to dig deep into like your music too for a bit too. So what was like your musical history and background growing up?
I say not a lot of instruments. There was one time where my mom tried putting me into piano lessons. I just wasn't fucking with it at the time, which is something that I would say I don't want to say I regret, but I do in a sense, because I wish I would have stayed in piano. That's like one of two instruments I want to learn. But musical background in terms of music, I would say my mom growing up was playing a lot of Peter Tosh, Bob Marley, Lucky Doobie. She had the VHSs with their concerts, like a 1-hour concert playing back to back. So there was that musical sense. What I got from my brothers was a mix. So I got the alternative from one brother, and then I got the rap and hip hop from the other brother. So the other brother would show me Pac, Biggie. He was telling me about the beef at the time, but he was kind of making me side with the whole Pac side because he was a Pac fan. He didn't really explain to me just the element of hip hop and what was going on as a general sense. And then I had my brother who showed me stuff like disco, MGMT, which helped my alternative side, which also helped me know what samples were, why samples are so important. And then you had my mom playing that classical stuff. Yeah. My dad also had a hand in that too. He had the Michael Jackson VHSs too. So Thriller scaring the shit out of me.